Good day, doctor. Today, for my endodontic simulation portfolio, I'll be using tooth 4-4 with normal crown morphology and no caries. For the pre-op radiograph, I'd like to highlight that the root is moderately curved and the estimated working length was 23 mm. For this moderately curved root, I could have used a floss for a better accuracy of measuring the estimated working length. For the excess cavity, I use a high-speed pear-shaped burr in the middle of the tooth and parallel to the long axis of the tooth. After drop-down effect, the cavity was enlarged buccolingually using a safe-ended burr, and straight line access was obtained by extending the buccal outline just nearly approaching the buccal cusp, as you can see here in the picture and also in the diagram. And for the pulpotomy, I measured 2/3 of the estimated working length, which was 15 mm, determined the glide path and also coronal flare using GG burrs, and make sure to lubricate the burr with each entry. After that, I placed intracanal medicament odontopaste using K-file. Using K-file is better compared to paper point because you can get an even coating. After that, the cavity sealed using double seal technique with a cotton pellet, Cavit, and IRM. After that, removal of temporary restoration, I would like to highlight that there was slight damage to the enamel at the side of the cavity. This can be prevented by leaving a thin layer of IRM at the border of the cavity, later removed using a scaler. For the working length determination, largest file that could bind to EWL was 25. The radiograph was taken, however, it was not within 1 mm of the radiographic apex, as you can see here. It was around 1.5 to 2 mm. So I added 1.5 mm to the previous estimated working length. Then the new working estimated working length was 24.5. And then I re-prepared the canal with size 10 and size 15 K-file. The largest K-file that combined to the corrected estimated working length was size 15. Another radiograph taken. And then the corrected working length was 24.5 verified by the radiograph. Because the tip of the K-file is within 1 mm of the radiographic apex. IAF was at 15. For the canal prep, I used MDFT technique. IAF was enlarged 2 sizes larger to MMF 25. After that, each file 1 size larger was introduced 1 mm shorter than working length at up to 1/3 of the canal, apical 1/3 of the canal, and make sure to recapitulate between each file. I was encountered using during canal preparation would be the MAF was gauged with the size 25 after doing the MDFT technique and then found to be loose at the working length. So after that, K-files of larger size was inserted to working length to obtain snug fit. I obtained snug fit at K-file size 35 at working length. The corrected MAF was set at 35. The canal was re-prepared using step back technique as mentioned previously. The reasons it could be because the stopper was loose and maybe error in measuring the K-file before insertion into canal. Maybe too long K-file to cause the apical portion to be overprepped. For the master GP, it was size 35 master GP inserted with tuck back. It was at the radiographic apex. For obturation, I did a final integration protocol, inserted the master GP, compressed the master GP using finger spreader. Before that, master GP coated with sealer, inserted, compressed, and then after that, inserted more accessory GP until the entire canal was filled up with GP. Obturation radiograph was generally okay except for one area at the apical 1/3 where there was a void, maybe due to inadequate lateral pressure or maybe delay after removing the finger spreader but before inserting the accessory GP. Cutting of GP 2 mm below CEJ, restoration with composite post-op radiograph. There was a slight void at the visual bone area, maybe due to because I didn't adapt the visual bone well using a sharp instrument. For the discussion, I would like to point out that we must be meticulous with cleaning and shaping canals. Pay close attention to the reference point. Make sure you use the same reference point each time you insert the file. And make sure the location of the stopper on the files will be consistent each time you insert the file into the canal. Because all of this may cause you to over-prepare or under-prepare the canal. A good technique is to recheck the stopper against the metal ruler to ensure the length of the file is right before putting the file into the canal. Second one, you must not rush. Make sure each step is completed thoroughly before moving on to the next step. This is important to reduce chances of errors. For example, if you have an inadequate access cavity, it might impede your vision into the canal and cause you to inadequately prepare your canal or maybe even broken instruments. Nextly, I would like to talk about we must have adequate knowledge on root canal variations, because if you don't have good knowledge on the tooth you're treating, you might miss out on additional canals. For example, in my case, mandibular first premolars is shown to that the single canal normally may divide into two canals and two apical foramina in 25% of cases. So we must be aware that this might be a possibility and try to search for it. If it's not there, it's okay. But if it's there, then at least you will not leave any underprepared canals. For the reflection, the lingual inclination of mandibular premolars, this is important to note because the crowns of mandibular premolars will tilt lingually, especially the first premolar more than the second premolar. So that's why you need to extend the access cavity buccally to make sure that you have straight line access. And that's all for my presentation. Thank you.